I remember being a really big fan of the Power Rangers when I was a little kid. So much so that when I actually saw that they were making a movie, I was ecstatic. I saw the making of featurette and I really wanted to watch it, but unfortunately, that had to wait until the VHS came out. And frankly, it was what it was. I actually remember that Saturday afternoon. My cousin calls me and he tells me that he has the movie, and I can't believe it. My moment has arrived. I go with my older brother and we walk to the house, which was about a few blocks away, and there I finally see it, and at the time I really enjoyed it. Now, Mighty Morphin Power Rangers was directed by Brian Spicer. This movie is actually non-canonical and it takes place in Angel Grove, although the actual filming took place in Sydney, Australia. I really enjoyed seeing our protagonists, the Power Rangers, go through what they did. Now, they are actually made of six different Rangers. We have Tommy Oliver being played by Jason David Frank, who is the White Ranger. Kimberly Ann Hart being played by Amy Jo Johnson, who is the Pink Ranger. Billy Cranston being played by David Yost, and he is the Blue Ranger. Aisha Campbell being played by Karen Asher, who is the Yellow Ranger. Rocky DeSantos being played by Steve Cardenas, who is the Red Ranger. And last but not least, Adam Park being played by Johnny Yong Bosch, who is the Black Ranger. Now, they actually have these really cool gadgets slash weapons in the beginning of the movie, but unfortunately, they lose their powers. And now it is up to them to go to the planet of Phaedos, save Zordon, save the day, and frankly, get some neat powers in the meantime. Now, our antagonist is named Ivan Ooze. Ivan Ooze is a shapeshifter that has come back to Earth to wreak havoc. Now, he wants to dig up his ectomorphicons, but his plan is actually to brainwash the parents of Angel Grove, and that in turn will bring his creations back to life so that once again they can actually take control of the human race. And he brainwashes the parents by shapeshifting into a wizard, who then tricks the kids into taking Ivan's ooze back home. The parents touch it and they become brainwashed. And get this, he makes the Tengu warriors by snorting out a giant purple booger. All in all, though, he's actually a really cool villain. I love that he shapeshifts, and also he's just a really entertaining character. I love Ivan Ooze. The conflict occurs when Ivan Ooze destroys a command center. Now Zordon is in trouble. The Power Rangers lost their powers, and it is up to them to journey to the planet of Phaedos, and along with the help of Dulcea, it is up to them to go into the monolith and unlock the power and become the Power Rangers once again. The climax occurs when the Power Rangers come back to Angel Grove, and now they summon their individual Zords, and now they battle the two ectomorphicons on the streets of Angel Grove. They do destroy one of them, and this enrages Ivan Ooze. He then fuses with the remaining ectomorphicon, and now Ivan Ooze, who is now a giant, is battling the Ninja Megazord. This leads into space, and now Billy has the idea of using Wright's Comet in order to destroy Ivan Ooze. They defeat Ivan Ooze by kneeing him in the nether region, and this causes him to fly back into the comet. I want to talk about Bulk and Skull. Yeah, I like Bulk and Skull, but this also pertains to what I talked about in my season 2 review. In my review, I said that Bulk and Skull, starting with the season, were actually becoming better people. And this movie actually does occur as well. They actually help the little kids save their parents. And I love that during the run is supposed to be really dramatic, but you have Bulk holding a pizza box and Skull holding a pizza slice. It's just really random, but just goofy. And frankly, I appreciate that because Bulk and Skull, despite being good people, are still the comedy relief. I will show you guys the DVD just because. Only they can save our planet from evil. And here's the inside. The bonus features are very slim. There's a theatrical trailer and also the making of featurette. The making of featurette I watched on a Sunday and I really enjoyed it, and also it made me really want to watch the movie. My final thoughts. Well, I watched this movie again because frankly, as a kid, I really enjoyed it, and so far this channel has had so many retro reviews, and I love just watching it or playing it again, seeing how I felt back then and seeing how I feel now. Maybe I feel the same way. But as it stands, as a little kid, I thought this movie was amazing. It was my favorite show in movie format. I really, really enjoyed it. But as an adult, I can see the flaws. I can also see the good points. And honestly, really appreciate the effort that they went to make this movie feel like an amped up version of my favorite show as a little kid. Everything from the theme song, to the suits, to the gadgets and weapons, to even the inclusion of CGI, it made the movie more grand, and I really enjoy that about it. Comment down below and tell me your thoughts on the movie. Did you watch it in theaters? How was it? Thank you for watching, folks, and good night.